Hello, this is the Provoked Prawn, here to talk to you about stability issues with MSI motherboards, and particularly i9 processors. That's the i9-14900K and 13900K, and the KF and KS variants as well. You may have noticed some issues with stability problems in games and on your system if you're running an i9, and particularly you might have seen this out-of-video memory error, which is causing games to crash and causing problems. It's actually down to the i9, and MSI has recently released a BIOS update for that, which can then help by using Intel's default settings to help improve performance. This is a BIOS update and a download that you can get, which then gives you a default setting with one click for Intel's default settings, which changes the power limits and actually reduces them down quite significantly. And historically, it was using a power limit for the water cooler setting, which was at 4,096 watts, which although was giving you more potential juice and therefore better performance, perhaps at the top end when benchmarking and things, it was causing stability issues, which is causing crashes. MSI is not the only one guilty of this, but you can see here with a comparison with benchmarking scores that using this actually reduces your Cinebench scores, unfortunately. But it's worth noting that Intel has actually made some recommendations of its own, and Intel has just recently released a statement pushing back against these baseline settings, not only from MSI but from other boards as well. And you'll notice here in this statement it says Intel is not recommending motherboard manufacturers use the baseline power delivery settings on boards capable of higher values. What they're saying is actually if you can squeeze more out, then you could potentially, but you just shouldn't be using these top-end ones. To that end, Intel's actually released its own default recommendation settings that you can change within the BIOS to tweak your BIOS and adjust it so that you're getting a stable results out of it, but hopefully not throttling the performance too much of your CPU and still getting what you should be for your money. So I'm going to go in this video to talk about some of the different things that you can do with it. First of all, I'm going to show you the MSI settings for it, and then we're going to go into more depth. Now, if like me, you've used a contact frame and some good thermal paste, and you have a case that's packed full of fans, hopefully with good airflow, and you're not thermal throttling, or you shouldn't be in theory, then you will want to do these updates. So I'm going to talk you through what to do, starting with the BIOS update, and then I'm going to show you the settings in the BIOS, both for MSI's default settings and the Intel recommendations, as well as showing you the benchmark comparisons at the end of what a difference that can make. I'll leave timestamps down below so you can link to the relevant sections, and I'm not going to purport to be a BIOS expert on this, so I'd recommend taking a look at the Intel recommendations if you are an expert and tweak all those settings yourself manually. But I'm going to show you some of the steps for it that I've done, that I've found, and the things that I've found to improve your system. So I'm going to give you some quick fixes on how to sort this out. The first one is going to be updating your BIOS. Now, obviously, I'm doing it for my carbon Wi-Fi motherboard here, so you'll need to get the right BIOS update for your system. And it's important to make sure you take care when doing this, because if anything goes wrong, you could potentially brick your system. So if you're a bit worried, you could potentially skip forward to later in the video. I'll leave timestamps down below on how you can jump to the particular settings in your BIOS that you're going to need to change. So first of all, head over to the MSI website for your particular motherboard. In this case, my carbon Wi-Fi, but make sure you find the right one for yours. Click on the support tab, and then click on drivers and scroll down and you should find a BIOS update there. You'll see this latest BIOS update is actually a BIOS beta version, and this one is designed specifically to work with those default Intel settings to ensure more stability. Now, you may find future updates, obviously, if you're watching this in the future, different BIOS versions, but download the latest one and that will then give you the updates you need for better performance there. Once you've done that, navigate your way over to the downloads folder, right click on the file, and then click to extract it. We need to put this on a USB thumb drive so that you can then easily access it in the BIOS for the BIOS update. So you can see, right click, extract all, find a drive that was suitable, and make sure it's formatted to FAT32, and then extract all the files to that drive. So when you've done this, you should find that the folder pops up, or navigate to it, and in that folder you'll find two files, and these are your BIOS updates. Now, the other thing you need to get is the ME firmware update as well. So you'll see there's also a download for that. So click to download that and we'll install that once you've gone through the BIOS update and you're back in Windows. But basically extract that file and the folder, and then in there you'll find a tool. MSI ME firmware tool, run that, and that'll update the ME firmware. You can insert your thumb drive into the port marked for the BIOS on the back there, and you can actually use a button to do the firmware update. And MSI has a guide to do this that I'll link to in the description. Essentially, involves just plugging in the USB drive we're going to put the BIOS onto into your motherboard and then pressing a button and waiting for the system to update. But I want to show you how to do it specifically from the BIOS, so you can follow a few other steps that are important. So once you've extracted the files onto the USB drive, click the start menu, click on the power button, click to restart, and wait for your system to restart. When it's doing that, then mash the delete key on your keyboard and keep mashing until we're in the BIOS. Obviously, pressing it more helps, just like pressing traffic light buttons. And then we go into the BIOS, and you'll see in the top right here, you've got the BIOS version and the current build date. So that's current build version we're on and the BIOS version. And then we can basically use the mFlash tool, which is in the bottom left. So click on the mFlash and that'll reboot you into the tool used for installing the latest BIOS version. Navigate to your USB drive and find that file within the folder. You'll notice that you've got the model name of your motherboard, the version of the BIOS, and the build date of that all down the bottom there, so you can be sure that you're using the right one and that you have the latest version. And then run the BIOS update. Don't turn your system off while it's doing it or remove the drive, because that will cause problems. When the BIOS update is finished, you should see this pop up as soon as you get back into the BIOS. You'll see that it now has Intel default settings as the top setting in here and the default one that you could choose if you want to improve stability. You'll notice down the bottom, it actually says warning, selecting tower cooler or water cooler profiles may reduce system stability. Please only change at your discretion. Now, traditionally, it was defaulting, especially if you're using an AIO, to the bottom one, to water cooler, which would give you 4,096 watts as your power limit and 512 amp current limit. And those settings are the ones that were causing the stability issues and the crashes and other things. So you want to change away from that potentially to the Intel default settings, which is now just one click. Don't forget to turn XMP back on at this stage as well, though. Now, if you click into the advanced settings under the overclocking section here, you can see that it is possible if you need to. So if you want to change back away from the Intel default settings, you can click on CPU cooler tuning, and then you can choose tower air cooler or water cooler as other options. Now, this makes it easy to do because otherwise you've got to mess around with a lot of settings. So it's sort of one click to fix things. But the main issues, the main areas of settings that are causing the problems are the long duration power limit, the short duration power limit, and the current limit as well. So you can tweak these settings manually if you want, but doing it automatically with these default settings will make your life easier in theory. And then just click to exit with that saved and off you go back into Windows. The downside to this is the drop in performance that you could potentially see at the top end. So on the left hand side, you'll see a Cinebench test where I basically ran it beforehand before the BIOS update. And on the right hand side is after the BIOS update with the new default settings. You'll see that there's 5,000 points less in this benchmark test, which is a pretty nasty drop in that. However, what you will notice is if you look at the temperatures and hardware monitor, we're not thermal throttling anywhere near as hard as we were before. So we're not hitting 100 degrees C on the performance cores, which is one point of note. And obviously gaming may be more stable, but we are taking quite a significant hit here. And this is what Intel was talking about with its recommendations, because it's not suggesting that you should throttle this CPU performance all the way down. From this list, which if you pause, you'll be able to see the data a bit more clearly, you can see that they have performance and extreme recommendations for the i9, KF and KS and standard K variants of the CPU, which is significantly different in the power limit options versus the Intel default settings that MSI is recommending. So tweaking the BIOS to match what Intel suggested, I ran those benchmarks again, and I'm now getting 19,049 points in Cinebench. And yes, one of the performance cores hit 100 degrees C, but we're not hitting quite as bad. We've got a higher wattage for the power limits and the score's better. And hopefully this will also improve the overall performance of the system as well. So now I'm going to just show you the tweaks that you can make to the BIOS if you want to do it a bit more manually. It's a bit more tricky because you do have to navigate your way around the BIOS a bit more, but here we go. So head over to your BIOS and then click on settings. I'd recommend first of all going to save and exit and then restore defaults. This will then just wipe anything else off and put us back to the start. Don't forget to turn XMP back on though, because that's one of the important things. And you can see I've reset my settings here from what they were previously and away from those Intel defaults that MSI has now put in place. If you go to the overclocking settings, you can see we're in expert mode there. And most of the settings we're going to need to change are actually under advanced CPU configuration a little bit further down. Once you click into that, there are a number of things in here to tweak according to Intel's guidance. We want to change IACEP support to enabled and support for 14th gen as well. And then do the same for GTCEP as well, and that for the 14th. And that's going to be enabled across the board now instead of disabled or auto. Then also under advanced CPU configuration, we'll look for TVB ratio clipping enhanced, and we're going to set that to enabled. There are a number of these TBV, which is thermal velocity boost settings, that we need to change. So we're going to change that one along with the ratio clipping, and just look at on the right hand side if you're not too sure about what these settings mean and the impact that they'll have. But these are the recommendations here that I've tried. So you can see we've got TVB ratio clipping enabled as well as the enhanced settings in there, so enabling both of those, and that will go along with the other settings. So there are quite a few different tweaks we have to make here. We also want to set TVB voltage optimizations to enabled away from auto. So all three of these are then set to enabled. All of the TVB ones are set to enabled instead of auto, or disabled as one of them was before. Then we look for Intel C state, which is also under the advanced configuration settings, and set that to enabled as well. It was set to auto before, but we just want to make sure that is on enabled mode in there. So just select that from the options. Then the main thing that we need to change is the duration power limits. So this is power limit 1 and power limit 2. And what we want to do is go into that and edit it. So you can see that you can click on the field and then you can type into it. So check the Intel list at the beginning. I've got a 14900K. So the recommendations are 253 for both the long and short duration power limits, and then a CPU current limit of 400. However, if you've got a KF or a KS variant of the CPU, it will be different. So look back earlier in the video at that Intel chart to get the recommended numbers for those. But you can see it here, that's what the default would be for the 14900K. Now Intel also has a power limit 4 recommendation, but I can't find that in the current MSI BIOS. If you know what it is, please leave that down in the comments below to help everyone out. And just a reminder that I'm not an expert on BIOS settings, but these are the ones that I've changed to improve my performance and get those benchmark results that you saw. And make sure you've got XMP enabled, and then hopefully you'll have the same thing. I'd recommend testing out both of these to see what works best on your system, because obviously every motherboard and CPU is different. So it is worth testing to see whether maybe the MSI settings are better for stability on your system versus the Intel ones. But hopefully this has been a helpful video. Let me know in the comments down below if it has, or if you've got any questions, or if you've got anything you want to share. Thanks very much for watching. You've made it right to the end of the video, you brilliant legend you. If you've enjoyed it, click that subscribe button, give me a thumbs up, and drop me a comment down below if you've got any questions. If you really enjoyed it, consider joining the channel and see the benefits of doing so. Check out these other videos. You might well find them interesting or useful. And most importantly, have a great life.